contrary, doing it different.
Lisa, 17, beautiful as ever, bruh. Graduated early, so she had a good head on her. Parents kinda strict, they know exactly what they want for her. But college and the grown-up life is what she wasn't ready for. Had her own plans, she can hold her own hands. She had dreams of being a model, cause her friends say she can, but her mama didn't want her to. But that's just what she gon' do. Made an Instagram, and she went and took some pictures too, and that's cool. She posted them just to see where it might go. And if they wanna book her, got her email in the bio. Time passed, nothing happened, but she got her likes up. Her followers went up too. Then that email come through like, hi, my name is such and such. I own a magazine, and you the perfect girl for the issue. Coming down in spring, show her mama. She replied, everything ain't what it seems. She told her mama, fuck you, you just mad. I'm living out my dreams. She wrote back, me on a magazine, yeah, I'm with that. I find a ride to you if you make sure I get back. And they replied, it's in a policy. I got you covered, just see your address. And in a bit, Uber will be over. She hopped up. While she getting dressed, Uber popped up. She walking out the house thinking she gon' get her guap up. Got in the back, the driver said, I know where to go. She relieved, cause the magazine man didn't let her know. But it's cool, he seemed cool, and the driver do too. So she going with the groove, because all this is new. The driver asked her, what's her age? She said, I'm too young for you. Then she laughed and said, 17, but 18 in June. She noticed he didn't laugh, but he did a slight moaning. So she asked, Mr. Driver, where exactly are we going? He ain't say shit. She asked him again, he ain't say shit. She said, I asked a question. He responded, shut up, bitch. She freaked out, screaming at him, let me the freak out. He pulled in the driveway and said, shut your damn mouth. The car stopped. She tried to open up the door and be gone. But when she felt the door, she saw the door handles was not on. She turned around, bam, he hit her. You know her lights out. She wake up, tied up, gag, bleeding up in some house. He walked up on her, rubbed her cheek, and then he pulled the Glock up on her, moved the gag, and told her if she screamed, then she'll fucking goner. So she ain't say shit, but think he on his rape shit. He sitting across from her, wondering how he gon' play shit. He got a butcher knife, wondering where is he gon' place it. She a pretty girl, should he put it in her face shit? But then he stood up, she crying, but he don't give a fuck. He just thinking when he kill her, how is he gon' pick her up? Where is he gon' put her at? As he stand behind her back, he whisper in her ear, stop the crying, I don't fuck with that. Think I had enough of that. She said, I got a question, let me ask you something. Why me? Cause this do nothing for you. He stepped back, his face looking like he was disgusting. Said, you practice for the next, so you really dying for nothing, motherfucker.
Contrary, doing it different.
Monica. She just turned 22. She done moved around, but the city life of her is new. She moved from a small town with her husband and they crew. Yeah, she got two kids. One is four, the other's two. She'll stay at home, mom. So she got a simple living close to her hometown, so her friends can still visit. So one day, they hit her up like, girl, we coming down. We want a home-cooked meal and some apple-flavored crown. She said, cool. 6 o'clock is when y'all can't arrive. Hubby's gone in the car, so I'll hit Uber for a ride. So just get here. Her friend joking, saying, don't get killed. She told a girl, I do this all the time, it's no big deal. They hung up, she ordered Uber and started to clean up. She got the kids together and that's when Uber pulled up. She walked out, kids in her hand, a bag too. Put the kids in back and told them, I'ma sit up there with you. So she hopped in, he told her, look, I know where to go. You leave the house with two kids, gotta be the grocery store. She just laughed, he told her, ma'am, I see this every day, but look, the trip is free, if I can make a stop along the way. She said, fine, a free trip, shit, yeah, I'm with that. He said, I left my cash at home and I gotta get that. He drove off 10 minutes later, pulled up to her house, went inside the house. Time passed and he ain't coming out. She went to knock, no answer. She pushed the door open, took a step in, then bam, he bust her head open. She blacked out, then woke up the same way that Lisa did while she was passed out. At her doorstep, he left a kid. The setup was the same as the last time he did this. He moved the gag and told her if she screamed, then he'll end this. She asked where my kids at. He said, I took the kids back and left them on the steps. And by the way, they got a cute laugh. He went and grabbed out the black bag, sat the shit in front of her, having flashbacks of Lisa and all he could have done to her, but he about to do it now, time to get to it now. He asked her what was she gonna cook, she just put her head down, he just shook his head now, he cool but he mad now. He said you can't talk, grabbed his knife and said don't make a sound, so she ain't say shit, he know how he gonna play shit. He told her if she cried for every tear she get a face stick, put the knife on her tongue, cut it real basic, told her close her mouth so when it bleeds she could taste it. She look him in his eyes for sympathy, so he look at her, stabbed her and he told her that's for trying to make me give a fuck. Think he had enough of her, he walk around the back to whisper in the ear but said fuck it, then sliced her on the neck. She screamed, freaked him out cause he didn't plan for that, and he told her not to holler so she gotta pay for that. She crying out, please tell me what I do for that, he said I can't answer that, and then he stabbed her in the back like 30 times. Max, 28, and he loves his family to death, but his wife died, so he raised his daughter by himself. His wife, she died from cancer, now he all about some health, and the shit is hard, he be feeling like he needs some help, but he gon' make it through, cause the way that he take it, his baby girl gon' take it too, cause the way that he face it, his baby girl gon' face it too, he just wanna calm her down, even though he's shaky too, so he gonna fake it through, time passed, money tight, bills coming in, so he let his car go, but it's cool cause he got friends, I mean ones he can't depend on, they always wanna help, until one day his baby girl was throwing up on herself, I mean it was bad, it wouldn't stop. Blood in it and all. She hit the floor crying, curled up into a ball. He freaking out, looking for his phone to make a call, just to discover C-Spire done cut his phone off. But it's cool cause he got Wi-Fi and the Uber app. Could've called 911, but shit, he ain't think of that. So he ordered Uber. Minutes later, Uber pulled up. He walked to his daughter, grabbed her hand so he can help her up. She still wasn't feeling good, but she wasn't throwing up. But he gonna take her to the doctor just so he can see what's up. They walked to the car, both got into the back seat, he told the Uber driver go, don't you see my daughter sick, the daughter in the back coughing cause she need water and shit. The Uber driver said here's my soda, she can drink this. The dad looked at him crazy, but she really need the shit, but he don't know this guy, so he like, first I'ma take a drink, which is what he wanted, it tastes fine, so he told her take a sip, and while she was drinking he started to see by Ada shit. I mean he on his night out, really on some sleeping shit, now he out, woke up tied up, very neat and shit, his daughter sitting right beside him, but she still in the sleep, the Uber killer sitting in front of him with a knife against his cheek. The dad went crazy, trying to move, but in the same spot. The killer told him, settle down. The dad screaming, not, I'm not. The dad was going more crazy, pulling on the rope harder, so the killer smiled. And then he slapped the shit up out the daughter, so she woke up. She crying, now the daddy crying too. Killer told him, if you scream again, then all this shit is through, so he ain't say shit. The killer feeling confident that he nothing to play with. The daddy asked why, he said, y'all, that's the same shit. And I don't know the answer, why bother, but let's talk about her dying, being watched by her father. See, this is new, he don't know what to do with her. He looked at her dad and said, I'ma make her comfortable. Grabbed his knife and put it on the right side of her jaw, moved it to the left just to make sure her daddy saw the blood running down her cheek. The daughter took it like a G, it pissed the Uber killer off, so he stabbed her in the knee. So the daughter went to scream, daddy trying to get free. The Uber killer panicked, so he gave her stab number 3, and that was in the chest. Then went to the leg, was about to hit her neck. He looked at her dad, he ain't watching, he stabbed him instead. Went back to the girl, stabbed her chest, all you see is red. That's not enough, he sliced her neck, now he know for sure she dead. He moved the daddy chair so he can be in front of her, told her mama write a note, her daddy was her murderer. I wanna do the same stuff to you, but I'm tired, but just know you never been nobody your daughter admired, motherfucker. She 19 and her semester done. She made the dean's list. It didn't matter that she's blonde. Summertime hit, so it's time to have some fun. She went home to the coast for her family and that sun, but her first stop is the beach. Got lotion for the heat. She lotioned up her arms and lotioned up her feet. She got something to eat, and I had to be discreet. She wanna just relax, so she tryna be low-key, and she did. She found a spot and set her stuff up. She gazed at the water while she sipped what's in her cup. She thinking about her life and how she came up. And when she see her mom, she gon' be happy as fuck, cause she got some news for her, a gift that she received. She know because of her, her mom gon' be in disbelief. She graduating college and about to get this cheese, so fuck it, she can't wait no more. So it's time to leave. Shit, she packed her stuff up in a rush like underlay. Made it to a car, called her mom like, mom, I'm on the way. I just came into town and I'm not too far away. I can't wait to see your face and I got some things to say. So she hung up the phone, she got inside her car, tried to crank it, it didn't work. Tried again, it didn't start. Tried again, it almost worked. So she made sure it's in park, and it is. She tried again, it didn't even make a noise. Damn, she kinda pissed, so she called her mom back, told her everything that happened while she downloading the app. She told her mom that she gon' Uber. She said be careful with that. News said that it's a killer, rejecting a car that's black. So she said cool, I got that well noted. I'm about to order now, I'll be there in a moment. She ordered her Uber, he was close like in a moment. He pulled up, she hopped in like, you know where I'm going. And he told her that he do, then he asked her what she do. So she told him she don't work, but she working hard in school. And she got some good news, and he said some news for who? She said news for mom and dad, and they don't even have a clue. He said cool, I'm happy for you, I got some news too. About to ask my girl to marry me, and I'm nervous about the move. See, I got her a ring, but you know I'm just a dude. So I wanna show to you just to see if you approve. She say fine, where is that? You gotta let me see. He said the ring is in the bag, the bag is right there on the seat. If you want it, you can grab it, it's too far for me to reach. So she reached for the seat and he stopped in the street. He put the rag on her face, now she grabbing on the seat. He trying to put it on her nose while she trying not to breathe, cause of that she can't scream. He screamed quit fighting me, she can't hold it no more. And he see she gotta breathe, and she know that shit too. Said in her head he got me. She stopped trying to fight, so he knows she going to sleep. Pushed her in the seat, fist is closed, back to knee. Looked back at her and said, by the way, this ride is free. She woke up, this nigga mad as fuck. She see inside his eyes that she really fucked up. He just staring at her, she wanna play tough, but burst out in tears and said, just don't kill me, bruh, I got shit to live for. This shit isn't cool. He stood up, she panicked like, why the fuck you move? And what the fuck I do? And why it's me you choose? He walked to get behind her. She told him, don't be cruel. My life is on the move. I just finished school. Just inside the car, I said I got some news. I'm about to get married, and I'm pregnant too. He snatched a chair around and said, I guess I'm killing too. Fuck your baby.